What's up, guys? PDC back here for a narration over an official ladder tournament match. This is for, I believe, round 4 of OLT. I'm sure you guys have seen some of these tournament games somewhere else in Smogon, or not Smogon, somewhere else on YouTube. I know Chimpact has uploaded a few, and I know GLB uploaded one for CL. But this is my game. This is for round 4. This is still regular XYOU, so this is not ORAS. This is just regular XY. But it's a decently deep in the tournament. I think this was like top... Actually, I can't give a number. Maybe it was like top 32 or something like that. But I thought I would upload this. This is going to be one of the last few XYOU games I'm going to be able to show. Because I'm running out of content. There's really not going to be any more important XYOU games to be played. And I really don't have that many great replays from tour. And this tour was so long ago. It's going to be hard to find them in the first place. But we're going to go ahead and begin this replay right now. I'm running a... Actually, after I do the team preview, he's running just a blatant hyper-offense, physical offense overload. As soon as I saw this, I'm like, alright, Azelf is rocks. It's probably Belgium, Azu, and that's probably Scarf Exodrill. Thunderous is probably Life Orb. It's just his physical overload. I'm running a team that you guys saw last time. I really like this team, actually. A lot of people don't, but I do. It is the Manaphy Sand team with stuff like Latios, Venusaur, and Scizor, EQ, HP, Fire, Latios. I already explained it, the team pretty well in the last video, so if you want to go and, you know, watch me explain the team in a deeper analysis, then go ahead and click on the Staticus vs. PC video and give that a watch. But we're going to go ahead and begin. Now, I know he's going to probably want to lead off with his Azelf, so I'm going to go ahead and lead off right off the bat with my Scarf Tyranitar. Now, whenever I see Azelf, I always crunch turn 1 as there's really no point doing anything else. Crunch plus Sand is going to be able to kill this thing, and even though he's going to be able to get a Stealth Rocks, I'm going to have the ability to defog them or spin them away, because my Latios does lack defog. It's really not that big of a deal, since nothing on my team really suffers that greatly from rocks being on the field. Pinsir, however, he's what he's going to bring out next. I figure he's going to go for a close combat. I'm just going to go out to my pretty physically bulky wall, obviously a Powdon, to tank a close combat. I don't have any move to hit Pinsir with, so I don't really have any way to beat it. It could definitely do a lot of damage when you return. So what I think I'm going to do here, taking advantage of the defense drop and taking advantage of his rather linear play style, I'm just going to go back to my Tyranitar. My Tyranitar is Scarf, and I was kind of worried he'd go for like a close combat here again, maybe expecting it, but he didn't. Instead, he just goes for return, but regardless, return is really strong from that Pinsir. It's going to do a lot to me because of Aerial Ace, now just the general threat Pinsir is. Here, I make a really good play and pursue him out, but that's going to be really crucial later, as this Pinsir, I really needed damaged, and that pursuit was just what I needed with the defense drop. So that was a lot of damage done to that Pinsir, a nice 63%. But he's going to go to his Exodrill, which I'm pretty sure is obviously Scarf. The only Exodrill you see on teams like those are Scarf. I've seen Assault Vest a couple times, but I figure, you know, this isn't some bladder random, at least I don't think it is. The choice specs, I think he's played in SPL. But he's going to be Scarf Exca EQing me, trying to kill me. Now, this sequence is kind of weird, honestly. Like, maybe if he didn't know my spread, but it was pretty obvious that I could definitely take an EQ. Maybe he's trying to crit me, maybe he's trying to stall me out. I don't know what he's going for here. But I'm just going to be able to slack off in this phase and get up to like 90%, which is really good for me, as a Powdon basically is my only real switch into Pinsir at this point, along with Bisharp and, you know, Exodrill, so it's good that I'm going to be able to keep this thing healthy. I'm going to go ahead and set up my Stealth Rocks here and get those on the field. Exodrill is his only spinner, and being locked in the choice, a choiced rapid spin is never a good thing. So at least him rapid spinning is not going to come without a consequence. But I'm going to go ahead and whirlwind the Pinsir out. I don't want to switch into Tyranitar there, as far as I remember, he could definitely kill me with return, which is why I didn't really want to risk it. He's going to go out to Whirlwind out to his Bisharp here, and he's going to go for the Iron Head. I was really afraid this would flinch, but luckily it does not. If that flinched, I would have been really, really pissed. And I'm just going to slack off right in his face. And his Life Orb Bisharp, so that is a bit stronger than usual, but it's really not going to be that big of a threat, as a Powdon can easily tank anything that throws at me. He's going to go out to his Thunderous, and considering I'd have very little special defense investment. I'm not going to be tanking a Life Orb HP Ice very well. So the thing I'm going to do is just switch it to my Tyranitar to take whatever he throws at me. I really thought he would have made a play here, went for like T-Bolt or maybe Focus Blast or something, or Super Power or something, but instead he just decides to go for the HP Ice, and T-Tar really isn't going to be that big of a help anymore. Be nice to keep around for stuff like Pinsir and Bisharp, but it was relatively low and couldn't really switch him reliably. I'm just going to try to pursue the Thunderous. Sadly, he decides to just T-Wave me instead of switching out, so he's going to be able to take out my T-Tar, but he has Life Orb, so he's going to be worn down pretty quickly by himself. And I definitely know that Scizor is going to be able to kill him with Bullet Punch at this range, regardless of how little attack investment I have. So that's basically what I'm going to go for here. This situation was kind of tricky. I contemplated going to just Hippowdon and slack offing here in his face, which honestly, now that I look at it, might have been a little better. Because now that I think about it, if I went to Hippowdon here and just slacked off in his face, I definitely would have taken, not that much damage from HP Ice. Probably wouldn't have done it over 56%. And he would have been forced to go with his Azumarill, and I would have kept rocks on the field. But regardless, the way I played it out was pretty okay. No really big errors there. He's going to go ahead and rapid spin away my Stealth Rocks, which isn't really bad, as this just gives me a I can still set up Stealth Rocks in this space here. It's just not that big of a deal. I just go ahead and I'm like, alright, well, I mean, can he really win here? Pinsir is still a threat, but I don't think I can really lose to it. But I just set up my Stealth Rocks again, because I really do want the rocks in the field to damage and kill Pinsir. As long as Pinsir is dead, it's a pretty clean game for me. He's gonna go ahead and go for a return here, and I'm just gonna whirlwind him out. I hope it doesn't go into something like Azumarill, and it doesn't. Instead, it goes to Bisharp. Bisharp can beat a Powdon if he gets a couple flinches, which was what I was pretty afraid of. I knew I could take at least one flinch at this HP, so I wasn't incredibly worried. I didn't think he was gonna get a double flinch there. But he's gonna Iron Head me, and it's not really gonna do any giant damage, and Powdon's gonna be able to take that relatively easily. He's gonna have to get a lot of flinches or a crit or something mixed in there in a row to actually beat my Impaldon with a Bisharp. He does get one flinch, and as soon as I see that, I started getting worried because I figured, alright, now comes the crit flinch and all that. 30% chance from Iron Head, that's strong, that's not good. I can't just take that without, consequence. But he's gonna Iron Head me again. His Bisharp is being worn down rather quickly by his repeated Iron Head attempts to flinch me. Which is good on my half, because this Bisharp is dying pretty fast, and Impaldon at this point has the ability to just stall it out. I'm gonna go for the Earthquake here when I'm at a health, which is reasonable, not risking the flinch anymore. I realize I can tank another X-Control EQ. I guess I could have slacked off there another time, but it really wasn't gonna matter in the end, I suppose. Stealth Rock is on the field, so I can freely go to my Venusaur here without worrying him doubling the Pinsir or something like this. He's gonna go for a Waterfall here, which does a decent amount to my Venusaur. It is offensive Venusaur, as every Venusaur is nowadays, and, I'm kind of like, alright, well, okay, I can just Giga Drain this thing, and see what I can do. He's gonna probably be able to 2-KO the Exodrill, considering I am offensive and that is probably very light Exodrill. I figure he's gonna have to be forced to go for the spin here to have any chance of winning. Is going for an EQ here would be really stupid and not help him at all. But I'm just gonna Giga Drain the Exodrill. I decided to stay in, as I guess I could have went back out to Powdon on the spin here, but I want an Exodrill dead, and I really don't have any complaints about that play. He's just gonna go ahead and go to Pinsir, obviously, and now I need to sack something. I need to sack something immediately. I need to make sure I can get something in here that really is not gonna lose to this thing. This was a really crucial part of the game, as if he SD'd there, I basically lost, as my Latios is hasty nature, so it can't tank any sort of quick attack. I think it dies after Stealth Rock, which really sucks, so my only choice here would be to go to something like Scizor and tank that, and if he played any more linear here, it would be like playing a bot. Yeah, that was kind of the whole game. He didn't make any any plays at all. Like, he made the clicking buttons, whatever. And it was kind of confusing, honestly, because I kept worrying in the back of my head, like, what if he's just gonna make a big play all of a sudden that's gonna blow me out of the water? But he doesn't, and he just ends up sacrificing the pincer to my bullet punch, which the crit didn't matter. I counted it. It did not matter. But he's just gonna go to his Azumarill. I kind of got a stroke of fear here, as I did realize this could be very bad if he's faster, as I believe Play Rough KOs offensive Venusaur from that range. But he doesn't, and I'm just gonna go ahead and hit him with a Sludge Bomb and kill the Azumarill for the game. And that, my friends, was game one. And now, I'm just gonna go to game two, since I don't want to make two separate videos or whatever, take two separate recordings. So now we're gonna go right into game two. I won game one versus Choice Specs, rather standard offense, and yeah, I'm gonna pause this and we're gonna cut to game two. Alright guys, we're back here for game two of the PVC versus Choice Specs OLT series for round four. This is once again a regular XYOU, and he's gonna be running a rather similar team with hyper offense, physical overload. I really was not sure what he was thinking here when he brought this. It honestly doesn't seem like it's that great of a team. This is like, these teams are really similar what he brought to what, like, teams, offense, basic teams like that were around in February. Like, really just hyper offense teams, just replaced Azelf with Deoxys D. But, I'm not really gonna complain about facing very linear teams here. I will say that this is kind of a strange game, though, and you'll see what I mean when we get to, like, turn 7 or so. But we're gonna go ahead and start the replay, and I can decide to, oh, look at that lag, I decide to go ahead and lead off of my limb. This is lagging, this is literally a replay lag, it's ridiculous. But I'm gonna decide to go off to lead with my Landorus T, and he's gonna leave it off with his Azelf. I'm gonna go for a Stealth Rock by Landorus T here, expecting him to think that I have Stealth Rocks and Ferrothorn, and this is Scarf Landorus T. But quite obviously, I am bulkier than, I'm the bulky variant with Stealth Rocks, so he's gonna go ahead and hit me with the Flamethrower on the T-Tar. You know, it's gonna do nothing. I was worried it would burn, but it doesn't, so it's pretty good. I decided to just go for a Crunch here. I, you know, really didn't see any point not. I figured he would just try to explode regardless, so it doesn't really matter. So now, with Azelf dead and my rocks in the field, I'm in a decent enough position. He doesn't have any sort of spinner or anything, so that means Pinsir is going to be taking a lot of damage from the rocks, and he's going to have limited switch-ins. But he's going to go out to his brand new online Crunch, and I'm going to go out to Landorus T in return to basically drop his attack and make sure whatever it does is not going to be able to kill me. But he does go for a Swords Dance, and I got a little worried. I didn't know what sets. I don't really know what SD Breloom's run, but I'm just gonna go for the U-turn, and turns out that's actually Adamant Breloom, which was kind of confusing. I didn't expect to see an Adamant Breloom here, which Swords Dance, but whatever. He goes ahead and brings it. I'm gonna go ahead and U-turn out to my Ferrothorn. I'm still afraid that he might have Spore, but really, it doesn't really matter. I was thinking while I was playing this game, like, if he had Spore, wouldn't he have already used it? Is he just clicking buttons? What is he doing? Why is he playing like this? This is really stupid. But I'm just gonna go ahead and drop him down to plus zero attack with my Landorus T, which, honestly, Landorus T is nice to have around is in case of something like Pinsir. I can get the minus one attack on it, but, you know, it's really doesn't matter. Landorus T, I don't really want to damage, but whatever is basically all I got to say. He's gonna go ahead and Mach Punch my Landorus T for zero damage, and then Bullet Seed my Ferrothorn. So this is the weird part of the game that I was talking about, like the weird, strange part, which is just like him clicking buttons and literally a SD Breloom losing to a Landorus T and Ferrothorn combo with rocks up on my side. So this was kind of weird. I thought that when he SD'd, I was gonna be in a lot of trouble, but evidently I really wasn't, and that was kind of weird. But I'm just gonna go ahead and U-turn out here on the Breloom. Now, this is where this game goes by relatively quickly, as you can tell. I'm gonna go ahead and U-turn out and kill the Breloom. I wanna bring in something fast here. I could have went, I didn't really want to go to Char Y or anything like that, because I don't want to take 50% from Stealth Rocks just to get killed by Thunderous or something like that. So I decided to go out to my Scarf Tyranitar, Web of Sand again, and, you know, T-Tar is a winning match against 3 out of 4 of his Pokemon, and I knew 100% that the only Pokemon he would bring in against my T-Tar would be Azumarill. I was worried for about Belly Drum, I really was, but I did realize this is basically my max defense for Earthorn. So I really don't think he can kill me in one hit. But I go for the Protect here to get a little HP back up. He can't beat me or sweep me with this thing, but he can do a significant amount of damage. BD Azu is a really big threat here. So yeah, I don't want to let this thing get off scot-free, and I knew scot-free, and I knew there was a chance that he could kill me with Play Rough or Waterfall, but I knew he could kill me with Play Rough. There was a slight chance that he could, unless I fucked up the calc. I think now that I'm thinking about it, I might have had more defense in actuality than I put in the calc. So maybe I didn't actually have to sack Landorus T there, but it doesn't really matter since Landorus T isn't doing anything that great anyway, 38%. But he's gonna go ahead and go for a waterfall here, and it nearly kills me, but my Gyro Ball is gonna actually take him out. And actually, now that I think about it, I think the calc might have been right. Damn, that did a lot more. But I basically sack Landorus T there just to get him down to -5, to +5, so he wouldn't KO me. So in the end, I guess it was the right decision. If he had Play Rough, that could have ended up a lot worse. He would have done a decent amount of damage to my Latios. But I'm just gonna let him kill my Ferrothorn. A 14% Ferrothorn is basically gonna do nothing to me at all here. Well, it's gonna do nothing for me at all here. I'm just gonna go out to my Tyranitar here, and hopefully I won't get paralyzed like I didn't last game. I avoided my paralysis once, but I guess my ticket was up because I do get paralyzed this time, and I'm like, oh fuck, this isn't good, this isn't fucking good. I started bracing my hand, and my head started racing, and I got really, really fucking nervous here. I'm like, oh my god, I'm gonna lose. This is, you know, it was 12 o'clock at night when I was playing this game, and my Wi-Fi actually cut out during the first game, so I'm like, oh my god, please, I don't want to play game 3 against this guy. I don't want to play game 3 because I know I'm going to lose game 3 if I play against him. But he does kill my T-Tar, and he ends up paralyzing my Latios, which really wasn't that big of a deal, but whatever, it's whatever really at this point. I go ahead and hit him with a Psyshock and kill the Thunderous with my Life Orb Latios. And this is where it gets kind of, oh shit, now it's going to come down to plays and guesses and 50-50s. He goes with Pinsir, and I'm going to let him kill my Latios, because there's no switch in I have for this Pinsir thing. And I'm basically, at this point, I'm going to have to rely on my best Pinsir counter. The best Pinsir counter in all of OU metagame, Spekkeldeo. And I'm not kidding, Spekkeldeo is the only only Pinsir counter I have left. I have to go for a Scald here, since Scald does kill Life Orb Bisharp, and I don't expect him to whip out an Assault Vest Bisharp on a team like that. I Scald Pinsir and I kill it, luckily. I was kind of worried that Scald wouldn't kill, but I calced it and it indeed did. And now is where it's going to come down to 50-50s at this point. Now, this is a crucial part of the game. He's going to kill my Keldeo with Sucker Punch. And now, I'm just like, oh shit, this isn't good at all. This is not good at all. This is bad. This is really bad. I'm going to lose this 50-50. Because remember, this is my Charizard Y. And Sucker Punch will kill me. If this was Charizard X, I wouldn't be worried. But this is Char Y, so Sucker Punch will kill me. Luckily, I roost on his Sucker Punch. He goes for Sucker Punch the first turn. I wouldn't have really done that if I were him. I would have went for the knockoff. It was pretty obvious to tell I was Char Y. But I'm not out of the woods yet. He can still, you know, crit me, or I can miss Fire Blast on my Charizard Y. I just go for it. And luckily, I do hit the Fire Blast, and the Fire Blast is going to be able to kill the Bisharp, which I was just like, yes, I 2-0'd my opponent for round 4, I don't have to play for another round, and now I'm automatically in the top 16 of Smogon OLT with this game. Yeah, that was top 16. So basically now it's gonna be harder because the winners bracket includes people like the Song, who just won Smogon Tour today. Congrats, buddy. Blue, let's see who else. Chimpact, and there are a couple other randoms, like four randoms, but they have to be at least of a decent caliber if they're in top, you know, winners bracket for so many rounds. But then again, OLT is quite literally littered with randoms. But on the 20-minute mark, I am going to end this video. Please subscribe, guys. And yep, that's pretty much it. Subscribe, comment, like it. We're trying to get this video up to, you know, about 40 or so likes, maybe 30 around there. But yeah, thank you all for watching, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace. More OLT to come. And next time, it will be Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. I'm out.